Children, once again welcome you in class 10th IT 402 module 4. Before that, till third module I have explained some important topics related to. Today we will discuss about the online transactions and internet security. Let us see what is online transactions. Most of you are familiar with these terms. It is a payment method in which the transfer of fund or money happens online over electronic fund transfer. This is called online transactions. In short, OLTP. Online transaction process, OLTP, is secure and password protected. The three steps are involved in this online transactions. These are registration. First we do registration, then we place an order, and then we payment by using credit card, debit card, or net banking or other options we use. The different types of online financial transactions are NEFT, National Electronic Fund Transfer, RTGS, Real Time Gross Settlement, ECS, Electronic Clearing System, and IMPS, Immediate Payment Service. You see about the e-commerce, the popularly known as electronic commerce or internet commerce. It refers to buying or selling of goods or services using the internet and the transfer of money and data to execute these transactions. Some popular e-commerce portals are given here. The advantages of e-commerce: the faster buying or selling procedures, it is easy to find the products online, the buying or selling can be done 24/7 hours, there is no fixed time, more reach to customers, there is no theoretical geographic limitations, we don't need to visit any place physically, we can take the better quality of services, no need to establish the physical setup, and it is easy to start and manage a business. These are the important advantages of e-commerce. Then e-shopping, or also called electronic shopping or online shopping. It allows consumers to directly buy goods or services from a seller over the internet using a web browser. And we can pay, the customers can pay by using credit card or debit card or net banking. The advantages of e-shopping: it saves time, it is a cost saving, the wide range of options are available, and the details of the products, the descriptions and review is also given, it is available online, so we can easily choose our product. The best product we can select on the basis of the descriptions. And the disadvantage is no trusted websites. Some websites are fake, so this is one of the biggest disadvantage of e-shopping. Then data security is another disadvantage. Whatever we are using for making a payment online, we are using our debit card, credit card, whether it is safe or secure or not, always it's a doubt. The shipping charge we have to pay sometimes. This is another liability. This is also the disadvantage of shipping and delayed delivery in remote area. Sometimes we are not getting the product on time. So these are the disadvantages of e-shopping. E-ticketing or electronic ticketing. This is a facility by using which we can book or cancel tickets of bus, trains and flights through the internet. It is very easy to book and cancel the tickets. We usually book tickets on the IRCTC portal, which is provided by the Indian Railway. Advantages are convenience, is scope for discounts also, sometimes we get the discount, quick and easy process, commission free, and free cancellation and easy refunds are the advantages of e-reservation ticket. On the basis of these topics, some questions have been given here. You try to write the answer. Then the last topic is internet security, the very important topics. Nowadays especially, we have to be very very careful when we are using internet. So how to stay safe online, we will study about these things. Internet security is a major concern nowadays. It involves network security and browser security. Online threats makes the computer insecure, like email is spoofing. It involves sending messages from a bogus email address or faking the email address of another users. It is taking the email address of another user. Phishing, it is a form of internet fraud where criminals aim to steal valuable information on credit cards, user ID and password for bank accounts. This phishing term is used in internet fraud. Spamming. Most of the time you would have seen that the unwanted email you are getting. So it is the act of sending large amounts of electronic junk mail that people have not asked for. This is called spamming. Here are some safety measures the computer and internet is given. First, to protect your computer, install protective software, that is your antivirus software. Choose a strong password. On the regular basis, you take backup of your data. Do not share your personal information to anyone. Scan all portable devices before use. Try to always use the licensed copy. Don't use ever the pirated software. Then secure your transactions. Be careful. And clear data is stored in browser. Very, very important. After using the internet, develop the habit of clearing the data from the browsers. An antivirus software. It is a program that detects, prevents from malicious programs such as viruses. We can protect our computer against viruses by antivirus software like Avira, Quick Heal, Norton, McAfee, etc. And the important thing is that if you have Windows 7 operating system, it provides the inbuilt security options in the control panel. The installed antivirus software displays in it. Thank you. And now the self-assessment question based on internet security. Define internet security and write some best practices used for internet security. What is the antivirus software? Give the example. A copy of data used to restore and recover the data is called DAS. Backup. Always keep your data secure. I hope you will try to write all these questions while you will come back. Stay safe and be happy. Thank you.